Electrical power has been abundant in recent years through the UK's coal, oil, gas, and nuclear-fired power stations. But times are changing quickly, and with our aging fleet of power plants, together with the ever-increasing drive for carbon reduction, are we leaving ourselves short on baseload power? By 2016, 41% of the existing coal and oil-fired power stations are due to close under the Large Combustion Plant Directive. Over half of our existing nuclear facilities will also switch off within the next 5 years. It's also probable that the last existing plant will close before a new one even opens. How do we expect to replace such a loss of baseload power generation? In 1990, 1% of our power generated used natural gas. By 2020, that figure is expected to rise to 60%. During that same year, it is highly likely that we will be importing 80% of our gas from foreign shores, with little indigenous production left. In 2009, 65% of renewable power produced was base load, but this is expected to drop significantly to 30% by 2016 and just 10% by 2020. Why? Wind farms. In 2009, on and offshore wind farms produced power for less than a quarter of the time. It's also questionable that climate change is diminishing wind speeds in northwestern Europe. 2010 has officially been the worst year on record for UK wind speeds since 1821. This is of serious concern, yet according to an Ofgem report, investments of over £200 billion will be required for offshore wind over the next 10 years. For the mathematicians amongst us, that's £55 million a day, every day between now and 2020. Allowing for inflation, that's £1 a day, every day, for every man, woman and child in the UK over the next 10 years. And we all pay. We have reducing control of natural gas resources and absolutely no control over the wind. Yet by 2020, at least three quarters of the electricity generated in the UK will use gas and wind as its fuel source. Our energy security will be reliant on the wind blowing and the gas being delivered on time. There is also no doubt that within the next 5 years, demand will be perilously close to our generation supply capability. The real difficulties will come when we are forced out of economic recession and demand starts to increase once more. Even if the UK government hits its renewable energy target of 15% by 2020, it's highly likely that 90% of that power produced will be intermittent. We must now find ways to increase the proportion of our baseload power generated from renewables and optimise our existing energy facilities. 2016 is just 5 years away. The ANEMOI plan is a strategic development plan to help towards bridging the coming baseload energy gap. Currently, over 95% of onshore power generation projects in the UK are being refused planning permission with a 3 to 5 year wait for grid connection. We must find ways of building power stations quickly without the rollout barriers which presently prevent us from doing so. ANEMOI could enable offshore power stations to be built within 2 years and deliver them to sites which have existing grid connections available. ANEMOI will use a ship and an energy crop biofuel as its dedicated fuel source. The plan will also act as a catalyst to create thousands of jobs in the shipbuilding, turbine manufacture and renewable energy industries. This new type of vessel is known as an enviroship, a state-of-the-art, environmentally friendly, floating mobile power station. It's the first of its kind in the world and will produce renewable power from an efficient thermodynamic combined cycle system. Southampton, England is the selected site for the proposed marine development. There are 5 key areas on the enviroship: 4 power generation modules, a process module, bunker tanks, loading equipment, and a power distribution complex. On arrival and hookup, existing transfer technologies, located on the aft deck, will enable safe and efficient ship-to-ship transfer of the biofuel. It will then be piped directly to the process module, cleaned and purified in a series of separators and pumped into the main bunker tanks below. The Enviro ship has its own dedicated biofuel storage in the form of 6 bunker tanks. Fuel will then flow to the settling tanks located on each power generation module, where it will be filtered and heated to obtain the right viscosity before injection into the turbines. Each power generation module has a combined cycle system installed with 2 dual fuel gas turbines rated at 17 megawatts each, a steam turbine rated at 12 megawatts, a heat recovery unit, and an electrical module. A total of 46 megawatts of clean power will be produced on each module from 3 electrical generators at 11,000 volts. The power distribution complex will host a remote switch room where power will be collected from all 4 power generation modules. From here, 184 megawatts of electricity will be metered and flowed to the electrical export tower and off the vessel via high voltage cables to the local substation onshore. The power will then be transformed up to 132,000 volts and exported to the national grid system. Now let's look at the fuel source and see how it removes carbon dioxide. Energy crops may hold the key to help offset man-made CO2. These crops produce clean biofuel and, as a side effect, remove carbon dioxide through the natural process of photosynthesis. Biosequestration is the capture and storage of CO2 by an increased volume or quality of photosynthesis, and is a potential way in which energy crops can exploit this planetary phenomenon. During the growing process, CO2 is locked into the energy crop. When combusted, the biofuel does not emit new man-made CO2 emissions. It simply expels what has already been removed from the atmosphere. The fuel source is, in essence, a carbon sink. Unlike many renewable energies, which only provide intermittent power to the national grid system, the ANEMOI plan produces a constant baseload supply of 184 megawatts. Through the simple combination of existing proven technologies compounded with Mother Nature, the Enviro ship will supply enough renewable electricity for 290,000 homes every hour of every day of every year, year after year. This ultra-low carbon power solution, together with its low emissions, will enable the ANEMOI plan and the Enviro ship to be classed as one of the most efficient, cleanest and carbon-friendly energy projects of the 21st century. We must reuse and optimise existing and new transmission assets in times of economic austerity. The potential to produce baseload electricity offshore is now here.